Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Coin News Extra Interview Session, a program where we invite our innovators and people who are doing great in the ecosystem to talk about their experience and interesting topics. So today we'll be talking about blockchain programming language. So we'll be able to know there are programming languages in the traditional programming world, but we want to know if there is a programming language from the blockchain world. So today joining us to talk about this nice topic is Akash Singh. Akash Singh is graduate engineer trainee, McLean and Rice. Akash, you're welcome to Coin News Extra.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for having me, man.
It's a pleasure to have you. So before we move to the topic of the day, just give us a brief about yourself.
Yeah, so I mean, just like a lot of people, I am right now a 2020 graduate. Just recently got into full-time job at what you mentioned, McKinley & Rice. I'm a BTEC graduate in electronics and telecommunication. Blockchain has been always the kind of field that I wanted to be in. Right now I'm working in it. Seems good.
Interesting. You're a programmer, so we want to look at blockchain programming languages. What are the programming languages in the blockchain space?
So, I mean, the programming languages, you can look at it from two sides. There are traditional languages that can be carried on to blockchain languages, like basically JavaScript as well as Python. These are the two kind of languages that are a lot of times used in blockchain space, as well as there are specific languages that are specifically designed to be used in blockchain. So, like, if you look at Solidity, Solidity was specially designed to be used in the Ethereum blockchain space. So, I mean, that is where I wanted to say that if you have a bit of knowledge from traditional languages, that is also a lot of times helpful to understand the new kind of languages that are specific to blockchain space. Like, if you look at Solidity, it is quite resembling to JavaScript. I mean, the syntax and everything, yeah, if you look at it, you'll basically look at the kind of the JavaScript programming that you can do, and whatever programming that you do, I mean, basically, if you have been doing some kind of programming, it creates a base for you. So whenever you learn one kind of programming language, the other kind of programming language automatically becomes easier, you know, to learn, so that you won't have that kind of exponential learning to do. So, like, yeah, the kind of languages, if people want to get in, I would say first learn JavaScript and as well as Python, even maybe Java, because if you look at, let's suppose we look at Hyperledger Fabric. So Hyperledger Fabric right now supports multiple languages that you can use to code on. So, and out of all of that, the most famous is obviously Python, because right now everything is being used in Python. So if you learn at Python or maybe even JavaScript, so all of those things are quite helpful. So yeah, I mean, those are the kind of programming languages that I would suggest anyone who is new into blockchain. And if someone is already into blockchain, I guess he would already have the kind of idea that he needs. Okay, like, this is what I need to use for this kind of project.
So there are specific programming language for blockchain, I believe. So are there similarities and differences between blockchain programming language and traditional programming language?
So traditional, you have to look at what blockchain truly stands for. Blockchain is basically is made for decentralized application. So when you talk about decentralized application, there itself you venture out from traditional languages, because traditional languages are usually used, what can I say, to create actually centralized applications. Like, suppose you are using a database somewhere that automatically creates a centralized application. But if you are working in blockchain, you cannot have a centralized database. So you basically store everything in on your distributed ledger, which creates which makes it quite a decentralized, decentralized application to tackle something. And the major major similarities is, I would say, that any kind of syntax or any kind of the way to write a code, that does not change a lot, because I mean those are the same things that you have used if you are used to in traditional programming. So I mean you won't have that much problem. You just have to pick up the blockchain basics. Okay, like this is how things has to be done in blockchain space. And if you look at the differences is where the decentralized and the centralized applications quite come into play. So like you have to look at, okay, no, we can't have any kind of databases and everything, because we need to store everything in the ledger. If you are talking about decentralized ledger, you cannot, you know, delete anything from the ledger. Whatever you write on it is permanent. So like you're storing on it for a permanent basis, and the only thing you can do is basically read from it. So it is quite imperative that you get it right in the first time, so that you don't have to again write it on the ledger. And so those are the kind of things. If you are looking at traditional programming, obviously there is more space, you know, to rectify your mistakes. But in blockchain, it is not, because everything is being, put onto the ledger, and where you can even see your mistakes that you have done in the past. So yeah, that is kind of a bit of vulnerability that I would say it for programmers, but for general use case, it is quite secure, because even your mistakes are going to be data into your blockchain journey. You will understand that, okay, there are certain kind of things that you need to look out when it comes to blockchain, and there are certain kind of things you look out when it comes to traditional program. But if you ask me, it all depends on the kind of project that you're tackling. I mean, even decentralized application, there are a lot of things that can be done, and it varies from application to application, like how much blockchain programming is overlapping with traditional programming and everything. So yeah, I mean, if I'm asked, it is mostly based on the kind of projects that you are doing. Basically, what are the things that you want to create using blockchain? Blockchain is a way to do it, like basically making something decentralized so that it is more secure as well as more accessible to the general public, rather than making it, you know, more capitalistic and centralized, so that one entity doesn't have that kind of power over others. Yeah, that's basically.
Yes, looking at it, we've been able to see, we've been able to talk about the programming languages, and we've been able to differentiate between the traditional and the between blockchain and the traditional programming language. So for one of the people that are intending to get into the ecosystem and they want to be coming to blockchain programming, what are some of the opportunities in the blockchain for them? Did you get me?
Right now the opportunities are I got you. You basically mean what kind of opportunities that one can look for in programming space, yes. Basically blockchain space. So yeah, yes. I mean, if you will ask me, the first thing is obviously being a developer. Being a developer is the most, I mean, what you'll say, is in demand right now, because in the world. So, and if anything is in its nascent, so whenever I talk about programming, there are a lot of things that you can do. So, I mean, if someone is looking to go into blockchain, he first needs to understand, like, okay, what kind of blockchain am I talking about? If I'm talking about basically public blockchains, basically, if he wants to work on like Ethereum or something, and if he's talking about permissioned or private blockchains, he's talking about Hyperledger Fabric and even Hyperledger Indy. Those are the kind of blockchain spaces. And I mean, a programmer can get into any kind of blockchain framework or anything, but it depends, like what kind of, like if you are looking at private and public blockchains to work on, then basically get onto Ethereum and Hyperledger Fabric and target the companies that you are looking. Like you have to check out at what company is working on what kind of technology. So basically, if you are talking IBM, Accenture, all of them are working on Hyperledger. And if you are trying to, you know, get onto the crypto side of it, there are quite a few companies that are working on creating their own ICOs and, you know, creating their own tokens as well as coins. So those are the kind of companies. Like Ripple is quite now famous in fintech. Yeah, so basically, if you look at it, a lot of the financial companies, so all of the banks that are working on, because they are the companies that benefit the most from all of this. So if you look at even UBS, I heard that UBS wants to work with Ripple to create its own payment gateway and everything. So yeah, those are the kind of things that people can look on, and you can even try to be, you know, a crypto expert or something. A lot of companies are also wants to get onto the crypto bandwagon. So those are the kind of things that you can look on.
Okay, interesting. Thank you very much, Akash Singh, for joining us today on Coin User Strike.
Yeah, fine. Yeah. That's it, yeah. Thanks, Lee. Thanks for having me.
It's our pleasure. So